These are the instructions on how to run the soundboard. The soundboard is always on, and when you come in, you're going to have to make sure that you're ready to load a show. And hopefully there is a load show. If there's not, you'll have to go to menu first. So when you say menu, then you click on show. And then you can go through and select the show that you want. And then you'll select load. It'll ask you yes or no questions. And basically you will say yes. Since this is already set, I'm not going to mess with that anymore. Okay, once you have the show loaded, we want to turn the monitors on. Not the monitors, but the power to the sound. But we want to mute these 1 through 8. And apparently only a few of them work, 1, 2, 5, 8, 1, 2, 5, 7, 8, but just turn them all until they all come red. Then you will come over here, and this will be the main power. You turn that power button on. And then you turn these 5 switches also on, starting from the bottom up. Just bring your finger up so that all 5 of those are on. And then you have full power to everything, monitors and sound. Then you can come back and you can turn these mutes off. Next, you may want to adjust the monitors. And the monitor mixes are 1, 2, 3. One is in front of the piano, usually Amber's. 2 is over by the Roland, which is usually Sherry's monitor. And 3 is Dar's monitor. And then you can start making the adjustments here that you need to. And then to get out of the monitors, just click it again and you're back to the regular settings. Now, if you want to adjust the house, we have different settings. We have settings A, which is for the instruments, and you can see that this is going to sit. Maybe you can't see it, but it does say kick, snare, hi-hat, tom, all the way through the Korg and the Roland. B starts talking about the vocals, so the piano, the green, followed by the Roland keyboard or the drum mic, which is the red one. And we've got the purple, the blue, the yellow, the orange, the white. And then LAV is for Pastor Chris's mic, and Pastor is actually Pastor's mic. And sometimes we want to run sound from the computer or an iPod or a CD, and the CD player is the bottom CD player over here when we're playing the CDs. And then if you go to the third one, it basically is the end of what we were just seeing. Okay. So, that gets us to this, and then we have the main sounds. This is for the main. This one here is for it. It's for the feeds, and I can't see what that says. Okay, so the one on the right is for feeds, record, and listening.
They're all off.
Okay, everything's off. 1, 2, 5, and 8.
Okay, all back on.
They're all back on. But if you do want to mute a particular
individual's input,
boom, that one is no longer working. And now it is. Okay. And then we also have these select buttons. So if you want to actually select somebody, it will light up, and now you can start adjusting their
tenor.
Okay, and if you want to adjust the house, do select, and then you can make any adjustments here that come through the house. If you want to listen to a particular singer to figure out how they're sounding, or trying to figure out who's singing off key, you click solo, and then that's what you can hear coming through the headphones. All right. I think that's about it. Good luck. Okay. And then this is the record CD, put the CD in, it'll read it, and then it'll say blank disc. Then you hit the red record button, and you wait until it's time to record, and then you press the play button. If it's not loud enough, if it's not going over here far enough, then you adjust this big round dial there. Thank you.